Fight Now presents Takedown Wrestling. Takedown Wrestling is brought to you by Brute Adidas and Sunflower Wrestling Supply, by Resolite Sports Services and Defense Soap, by ASICS and Mass Mutual, by Clinch Gear and Kamen Agri-Foods, by Zebra Mats and Worldwide Sports Supply, and by InterMatWrestle.com. Now from the Takedown Wrestling Studios, here's Scott Casper.
Hello again, everybody. It's Takedown. I'm Scott Casper. America's wrestling news starts now. The second-ranked Cowboys of Oklahoma State took on the top-ranked Hawkeyes of Iowa. John Smith had his team prepped and ready to square off at Carver Hawkeye as nearly 16,000 fans twisted the turnstiles to watch the battle between our sport's two most storied programs. The Hawkeyes rode an 84-duel unbeaten streak into the bout. It was apparent that rankings didn't mean much to either team as the Pokes and Hawkeyes split the duel at 5 apiece. Well, when it was all said and done, the duel was tied 16-all, and the rules called for a decision, so we went to the third level of criteria. The Pokes pulled away on that level, which was a total point scored in the duel. OSU held a 54-49 advantage over the black and gold, good enough for an extra point and a huge W for the Cowboys. Hit rewind. Here's how it all went down. The Pokes heavyweight Alan Galagayev started the duel with a bang with a 10-3 major over Iowa's seventh-ranked big boy, Bobby Telford. With the creosote smell still hanging in the air, the Hawkeyes popped off wins at 25, 33, and 41. All those bouts featured top 10 matchups. Firing now on all cylinders, second-ranked Matt McDonough blew out the Cowboys' ninth-ranked John Morrison at 25, picking up a 14-4 major, tying the team score at 4. In the most anticipated bout of the night, top-ranked Jordan Oliver battled fourth-ranked Tony Ramos to an end of regulation tie of 3-3. Ramos scored the 4-3 upset in overtime when Oliver was called for his third caution and no other points were scored. It was Oliver's first loss of the year, breaking his streak of 10 consecutive wins by fall. OSU's ninth-ranked Josh Kindig nearly answered with an upset of his own over fifth-ranked Montel Marion at 41. Kindig held on to a 6-5 lead with just over 30 seconds remaining, but Marion scored a takedown and a two-point near fall to seal a decision and put the Hawkeyes up 10-4. The Cowboys tied the score at 10-10 after second-ranked senior Jamal Parks picked up an 8-3 win over Mike Kelly. Fifth-ranked Albert White scored a late takedown to secure a 7-3 decision over Nick Moore at 57. The Hawkeyes and Cowboys went back and forth for the remainder of the night, giving the capacity crowd everything they came for. The 10th-ranked Mike Evans of Iowa defeated Dallas Bailey 5-1 at 65, and at 74 pounds, OSU's Chris Perry earned an escape in the first tiebreaker to knock off 9th-ranked Ethan Lofthouse 3-2. That's Ethan Lofthouse 3-2. Iowa's Vinny Wagner edged out Chris McNeil at 84 pounds to set up the last bout. Dropping down from heavyweight, the Cowboy Blake Rochalt made the most of his 97-pound opportunity when he defeated 15th-ranked Grant Gambrell of Iowa 8-4 to tie the match at 16-all. Now the fans and teams had their chance to voice their opinions, and then the referees went to the scorebook and tallied their own. Oklahoma State was declared the winner, denying the Hawkeyes another win in the record books. An outstanding match by all, one in which even the guys guarding the doors got into the picture early on in the evening. We appreciate it. Well, the war in West Lafayette took place last Friday night between the Boilermakers of Purdue and the 7th-ranked Illini in a very special way. It was Military Appreciation Night. The Fighting Illini scored a 24-9 victory at Holloway Gymnasium just next door to the newly renovated Mackey Arena, the host site of this year's Big Ten Championships. Well, the Boilermakers got off to a slow start after dropping consecutive decisions at 41-49, which put them in a 6-0 hole. Purdue freshman Brandon Nelson was unable to hold off Illini junior Darryl Thomas at 41, who had rallied from behind to avenge a Midlands loss with a 13-11 decision. Nice job there. Illinois' fourth-ranked Eric Terrazas knocked off seventh-ranked Boilermaker Ivan Lupinchansky with a 10-4 decision at 49. Now, Purdue got on the board at 57 when Tommy Trichard scored an impressive 11-9 OT victory over Illinois sophomore Jackson Morse. Illinois regrouped at 65-74 as both Conrad Poles and Dan Stelter scored back-to-back decisions to give the Fighting Illini a 12-3 lead going into intermission. Purdue's 19th-ranked Braden Atwood put points up for the Boilermakers with a 4-2 decision of his own over Tony DeLago at 84. The Illini answered at 97 with a quick fault by Mario Gonzalez, bringing the team score now to 18-6. Purdue's heavyweight Roger Vukobradovich got into the action and kept the Boilermakers alive when he ousted Illinois big man Pat Walker with a 4-2 overtime victory. Illinois' dynamic duo of 25 and 33, the fifth-rated pair of Jesse Delgado and B.J. Futrell, closed out the duel with the decision for the blue and orange. We talked with big men Tom Erickson, Scott Hinkle, the head coach, Braden Atwood, and Roger Vukobradovich as well.
It was pretty easy, honestly. You know, you guys sat here front row, watched the match, and I think one of the keys for Illinois, they were aggressive. You know, if you listen to me a little bit, I'm telling guys, you know, dictate tempo, dictate, you know, what happens on the mat. And I think Illinois did that.
Anytime you can, you know, win three matches, you got to be happy about those. But otherwise, it wasn't very good. They came out and were aggressive and took it to us. And that's what I just told them. If you want something, you got to go get it. And they dictated the tempo in most of those matches. But there were certainly some positives in a couple of the weight classes. We got pinned at heavyweight last year, so that was a nice win for Roger. And Atwood's having a great year as a freshman. And, of course, Churchard coming off kind of a breakout tournament for him at Midlands and down early to come back against a tough wrestler. You know, there are some positives.
I don't know. I like to end it in regulation. It's not that I don't think I have the gas to go into overtime. I'd like to get the job done early. I think this is only my second overtime match of the year, so I like to score. But Pat Walker's a tough kid. He's really, really tough to score on. I mean, I think it's evident now. I think he's taken a couple. I know he took Bobby Telford of Iowa in a tiebreaker. He took Trice into a tiebreaker. So that's kind of his style.
Midlands, I did pretty well. I think I did great up until the last day. I got beat by Hamlin, who he's a great wrestler. But not taking anything away from him, but I think I should have gave him a little better match. And then for third and fourth, I didn't wrestle very well. But, I mean, better to do it now than the Nationals.
Fighting Illini, head coach Jim Heffernan talked about his team's victory.
Right now, getting through the grind portion of the season with all these Big Ten duels, you know, wrestling these guys Friday, Sunday, and, you know, we have Minnesota against next Friday. So it doesn't get any easier for us having wrestled Iowa already. So we're getting into the Big Ten portion of it pretty quick.
Well, this duel was a special one. Purdue named it Military Appreciation Night. At intermission, the Boilermaker faithful honored U.S. Marine Corporal Matt Bowman with a special edition camouflage Purdue singlet. The crowd, media, and fans all rose to their feet as they presented the rare singlet to Bowman. The Boilermakers also auctioned the 10 game-worn singlets, raising some $17,000 for the National Semper Fi Fund. Bowman is a former McCutcheon High School wrestling standout and a member of the Boiler Elite Wrestling Club. Well, this year marked the new location for the NWCA National Duels. The tournament moved from Cedar Falls to Springfield, Illinois, and fans were treated to great wrestling action. Let's start with D2, as third-ranked St. Cloud State shocked the crowd after downing top-ranked Newberry in the finals 23-12. Earlier in the day, the Huskies had defeated the always-tough Upper Iowa University 22-13 to advance to the championship bout. Jason Bryant caught up with St. Cloud Steve Costanzo.
Oh, it's just one step closer to that process. This is one of the goals, just winning the national duels. It was a big deal to us. But it's not the end of the season. You know, our guys need to enjoy it on our 10, 11-hour bus trip home and then get back to work on Monday, Tuesday. So it's part of the process and it's part of our season goals, but it's not everything. But we're sure happy about this.
Well, next up, it was D3. Top-ranked Wartburg College beat second-ranked Augsburg in the finals for the second year in a row, this time by a score of 29-6. In the 12-year history of the tournament, Wartburg and Augsburg have now met 11 times. I said that right, 11 out of 12 times. Talk about powerhouse performances.
I mean, we love the tradition that thing we got going with Augsburg. I know they're a great program, but, you know, it's been a fierce competition. We end up on the right side of most of the matches, but we know it's going to be a lot tougher next time.
In the NAIA ranks, second-ranked Grandview University put up big numbers by winning all four duels with a combined score of 132-37 en route to the school's first team title in any sport. The fourth-year program won 31 of 40 bouts in their third tournament appearance. The Vikings head coach Nick Mitchell talked with JB.
It's awesome. It is. I mean, that's what we talked about from day one. And it's been a long time. These seniors that wrestle here, those guys, they were here from the get-go. I mean, Travis Evans, Ty Noller, Nick Coffin, those guys have been here since year one. When this seemed like something crazy to talk about, but we've been talking about it since then. So it's a tribute to those guys who stuck around.
Well, at the JUCO level, top-seeded Iowa Central won its fifth dual title with a 31-10 win over third-seeded Labette. The women's division was ruled by top-seeded Oklahoma City University. They defeated second-seed King College 25-14 to add another title for Randall Stars. Jason went one-on-one with Archie Randall.
We wrestled a little bit flat, I thought. We had a couple matches that we haven't lost to those girls in three or four times, but you wrestle four or five times, that's the same opponent, things can happen.
Congratulations to all the teams that competed, and a special thank you to Jason Bryant of USA Wrestling. Well, Takedown Wrestling headline news is up next, so stay tuned. We'll be back.
I'm Randy Couture, and this is Extreme Couture. Over 24,000 square feet, on-site physical therapy, and the best MMA team in Las Vegas. We have classes for men, women, and kids of all ages. Memberships start at just $20 a month. Call for more information, 702-616-1022.
And I am the only man in MMA history to possess titles in two weight divisions simultaneously. I use my own money, and my own blood, and my own sweat to build the most respected performance brand in MMA. I grew up wrestling, and I've grown old fighting. I am a proud father. I'm an MMA legend. I am Dan Henderson, and I am Clinch Kicker.
Are you ready, America? Then let's get it on with Fight Now TV. Your front row seat, 7 days a week to experience all the hard-hitting action, news, and entertainment from around the fight world. From world-class boxing events.
Here we go, the main event!
To mixed martial arts showdowns and other combat sports matchups.
Here we go!
Fight Now TV delivers the hits and more. Fight Now TV also offers unrivaled access to the fighters and insiders who make the fight game happen around the globe. As we go from the training camps to the weigh-ins, press conferences to the matchups, Fight Now TV is there before and after every belt. Fight Now TV also features original series found only on Fight Now.
There you have it.
Stop on by.
It's time, fight fans. Your channel has arrived. All the fights, all the names, all the action. Call your television provider and tell them you want to get it on with Fight Now TV.
Way of life is to defend the American way of life. Every day, we take a stand for our nation, for each other, for us all. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Welcome back. It's time for Takedown Wrestling Headline News. All right, Minnesota Gopher and Olympian Jake Dietscher's career is sadly over due to a series of concussions that started when he was 7. The redshirt sophomore battled the issue since enrolling at Minnesota, and after meetings with specialists, he was advised to hang up the shoes. Not a way we want to see any athlete go out, and certainly not somebody who made it to the Olympic team as a senior in high school. An incredible career cut short. But best of luck to you, Jake, in your future decisions. The 12th-ranked Cornhuskers of Nebraska keep winning and improve to 10-0 in the year with an 18-16 victory over 6th-ranked Ohio State. A trio of bonus points propelled Nebraska to a school record 10 straight dual victories. After the duel in Lincoln, the Buckeyes traveled north to Minneapolis to take on the Gophers. While it wasn't the weekend the Bucks were looking for, as the 3rd-ranked Gophers won the first six bouts during a 24-13 victory. Early on in last week, Iowa State Cyclones finally got their first victory of the year over 15th-ranked Arizona State. Four bonus points wins by Iowa State pushed the Cardinal goal to a 25-14 margin over the Sun Devils, an important win for sure for Coach KJ and his squad. Fast forward now to this past weekend, the Clones were looking for revenge in their second straight win as they took on the 11th-ranked Tigers of Mizzou, this time at home. The Cyclone faithful didn't get the results they wanted. Iowa State was looking to avenge an early season loss. Last time they met, the Tigers won 31-10 in Columbia, Missouri. Well, this time the Tigers rolled through Ames and topped ISU for the second time on the year with a 24-11 victory. Fresh off a runner-up finish at the Midlands, the 15th-ranked Wildcats at Northwestern won 8 of 10 over the Wisconsin Badgers. The Wildcats tallied 5 bonus points to tally a 33-9 victory over the Mighty Badgers. Let's take a look at all the scores from the last 7 days on the Mat.com's College Scoreboard on a Roll.
This way, you learn to fight for everything you make. Something big is slightly out of reach. You learn to fight till you're standing on your feet. Looking back on it now,
well, that'll do it for this week's Takedown Wrestling headline news. Well, the 1-versus-2 matchup this last week in a Carver Hawkeye wasn't the only action wrestling fans got to see there. No, sir. During the intermission of the Iowa-Oklahoma State duel, former Hawkeye and Cowboy Brent Metcalf and Steve Mocco took part in freestyle exhibition bouts to help promote the 2012 Olympic trials that will take place in Iowa City April 21st and 22nd. Two-time NCAA champ world team member Brent Metcalf squared off against Canada's Hazelin Garcia at 145 pounds. Metcalf won the first period with a push out from the clinch, and then scored a late takedown in the second for a 1-0-1-0 victory. We talked to the Olympic hopeful.
I don't know if you can match this because of the rivalry, but it will be similar in the amount of people here and the energy, and definitely the finals of those trials, because it means a whole lot. This means a lot because of rankings, because of pride, because of what the rivalry is all about. But, I mean, take that and then put it on Olympic first on top of it. You know, because these rivalries are still there. I still got rivals with the guys that I'm wrestling.
Well, the one-time Hawkeye-turned-Cowboy Steve Mocco won NCAA titles for both Iowa and Oklahoma State in his collegiate years. The former Blair Academy star and Olympian finished off his German opponent in two straight periods with multiple takedowns for a 1-0-2-0 score. The 30-year-old Mocco represented the U.S. in the 2008 Olympics, placing 7th and is a 5-time U.S. team's trial runner-up. The 30-year-old Mocco represented the U.S. in the 2008 Olympics, placing 7th and is a 5-time U.S. team trials runner-up. We talked to the Bear about the match.
Yeah, it was a real treat for me to wrestle here in front of the crowd in the stadium again. It's been probably close to 10 years since I wrestled in a home match here, being like the home athlete, so it was a really, really good treat, and it's awesome when you wrestle in there, you know. It's awesome. It's an awesome feeling, you know. It's like getting hit by lightning of energy.
Well, Penn State won the 2012 Southern Scuffle title in the strength of 4 individual champs. The Lions enjoyed titles from Frank Molinaro, David Taylor, Ed Ruth, and Quentin Wright at 49, 65, 74, and 84. Taylor also earned OW honors after nearly pinning his way through the 65-pound weight class. The Gophers rolled in at 2nd with 3 individual champs in Zach Sanders, Chris Dardanes, and Tony Nelson, that's 25-33 in heavyweight. Mizzou grabbed third as Brent Haynes secured his 97-pound title. Scuffle outstanding wrestler David Taylor talked to us about his performance.
It's kind of something that I not necessarily expect. I just hold myself to a level where I want to go out and score as many points as I can every match. I just told myself, for a while now, that if I'm going out and scoring the points, and just keeping it simple like that, and that's when I'm wrestling the best.
Molinaro is, as I said, on becoming Penn State's fifth four-time All-American.
We wrestled really tough, and it was cool, too, because we got to bring, five extra guys, and they got to get some big matches in, too, and I think, they really stepped up, and Penn State showed how much depth we really have in those other weight classes. We did 57, won some matches at 41, 74. We had two guys in the finals. So I think did a real good job there and continue to do what we're very good at and score bonus points.
Indiana senior Matt Paulus captured 5 wins, 2 pins, and 2 majors en route to a 4th place finish at the scuffle. Marks the 3rd time Paulus has placed in the tournament. With 109 career victories, he's only a couple shy of cracking the top 10 in Hoosier history.
Yeah, it felt good that I bounced back and made it to the, 3rd and 4th place match after losing the first day. But, obviously I still wish I would have gotten 3rd, and before that, I wish I hadn't lost at all. I really like that I got the 5 wins, but, what stays out to me is the 2 losses, because that's what I'm, keeping with me as far as learning the material for the future.
Well, this year's Southern Scuffle was held on the campus of Tennessee Chattanooga for the first time. Chattanooga head coach Heath Esslinger was quick to relocate the prestigious scuffle after UNC Greensboro vacated their program. Esslinger talked to us about the success of the event.
We believe that our alumni deserved it. They were the ones, the guys who support this program are the guys that were here in the mid, late 70s, early 80s when the Southern Open was here, and Oklahoma State and Iowa and Oklahoma and, the LSUs and all those guys had teams, and they were watching that kind of wrestling right here in Chattanooga. So we were thrilled to bring it back for those guys, because it's been a long time coming, and we believe that it's here to stay now, and that people are excited about booking rooms for next year for the Southern Scuffle back here in Chattanooga.
Well, at the 49th edition of the Midlands Championships, we took a moment to catch up with Olympian and Bellator standout Ben Askren. We'll have that story and more in our Extreme Couture segment when we continue. Stay tuned.
Athletes, coaches, Defense Soap is developed by wrestlers for wrestlers, and now for fighters too. World champion Lee Kemp is a believer. The active ingredients in Defense Soap will help you prevent MRSA, staph, ringworm, and many other skin infections. Defense Soap will keep you on the mat and in the battle. Offense wins matches. Defense keeps you on the mat. Defense Soap, the science behind your health.
I remember the moment.
I'll never forget that moment.
That changed my life.
At that moment, it hit me. This is why I joined the Guard. We're soldiers, always ready to protect our country. But we've also got communities. Family, friends, neighbors who count on us. I couldn't believe it. I just saved a life. Somebody from my hometown.
See what it means to be a citizen soldier at NationalGuard.com.
We make it easy to outfit your team so you can keep your mind on the mat. We stock all the essentials your team demands. Custom in stock singlets, shoes, headgear, knee pads, antifungal soaps, warm-ups, sport bags, and much more. Worldwide Sports Supply has been serving the wrestling community since 1981. Put our experience to work for you. Let us be your one-stop wrestling supplier. Trust us to handle your team gear from head to toe.
ASICS has been there. They've been the lifeblood of the sport. It's been a long time, and they've been at the top of the game every year, forever. And I'll tell you what, now that I think about it, maybe that's where I've gotten my inspiration, because I always want to be on the top of my game in wrestling, and I think that's where ASICS is and wants to be as well.
be solid the whole time. So pass the script. Amazing things are becoming from the show. See where the opportunity is and execute. That is composure. Get the point, get a world cup victory, make the Olympic team. Minutes away from representing the United States of America.
Well, each year at the Midlands Championships, we run into familiar faces. Olympian and Bellator champ Ben Askren was roaming the crowd. Bellator Season 5 champ brought some youth from his kids' club to catch some elite collegiate action. We talked to the Funky One about his current training location and future fight.
Yeah, I got a wrestling academy in Wisconsin, Askren Wrestling Academy. Wanted to experience some wrestling with the kids, so brought them down here, checked out all the wrestling in the semifinals and the finals and the place matches. It was good.
You got to wrestle in the event last year, but other than that, you never actually got to compete in the actual tournament,
right? I competed in the Midlands my redshirt year. I went 1-2. I wasn't quite that good yet my redshirt year, so I did a lot of improving after that. And someone just told me it's 50th anniversary next year, so I might think about actually wrestling in the tournament.
I'm sure a lot of people will be excited to see that.
Yeah, I would be excited for that. That'd be a lot of fun.
So what's the next step fighting-wise, then? Where are you training at?
I'm up in Milwaukee at Duke Rufus Gym. Great gym, a lot of UFC fighters there, and you know, great coaching. And then my next fight will be in March.
Okay, do you know who that's against yet?
Yeah, it's going to be Douglas Lima. He won the tournament, Season 5 welterweight tournament, so I'll be facing him.
Well, that wraps up America's Wrestling News. Tune in and listen to the archives of our radio show when we included Scott Hinkle, Tom Erickson, Jeff McCall, and Jeff Murphy among our guests. Our recent Intermat standalone interviews include Kendrick Maple, Matt Paulus, David Taylor, Heath Esslinger, and many others. You can catch those at takedownradio.com. You can tune in live Saturday mornings, 9 to 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. And so, for today's show and from our studios here in Des Moines, Iowa, I'm Scott Casper. And good night.
Takedown Wrestling is brought to you by